Philippine President Marcos Jr. admits he wants to synchronize the country's midterm polls with a plebiscite on constitutional amendments. He believes this would save on costs, but at least one lawmaker says this may be problematic. RG Cruz has tonight's top story.
Before flying to Australia, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. maintained it is more practical for a plebiscite on a new charter to coincide with the 2025 midterm elections. The Commission on Elections has commented that this move would not have any bearing on their ongoing preparations, only that the ballots will be longer.
Pinag-aaralan talaga namin yun dahil kung ipaghihiwalay natin yung eleksyon at saka yung plebiscite, parang dalawang eleksyon yun eh. Napakamahal. So baka maari kung isabay natin yung plebisito sa local elections na gagawin sa Mayo na next year.
The president said he will talk to Speaker Martin Romualdez about this. Some congressmen had been vocal that the plebiscite be held before the polls to insulate it from politics.
It's very hard also to have a plebiscite before the election kasi mabubulilyaso yung preparation para sa halala.
A House leader sees a path for the president to get his wish and still comply with the constitutional requirement for a new draft to be subjected to a plebiscite no earlier than 60 days but no later than 90 days after a new draft is ready.
Assuming, for the sake of argument, that we are able, wishful thinking lang to, that we are able to approve this before the Lenten season, the matter of both of houses of Congress I'm referring to, the matter of submission for plebiscite to the COMELEC, i-adjust na lang to be within that period.
Senator Sonny Angara believes the proposal is doable.
Palagi ko may oras. Tingin ko. Kasama na yun. It's only March. Maraming buwan bago mag-October. So, maraming oportunidad para plantsahin yung mga detalye.
Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri echoes the Commission on Elections pronouncement that it may save 13 billion pesos if the plebiscite and the elections are held simultaneously. But at least one lawmaker expresses concern with this timeline. Danao del Sur Representative Zia Alonto Adyong fears such a move could politicize the issue, with candidates possibly using charter change as part of their platforms. Still, he says the House is sticking to its March deadline of finalizing proposed amendments to the economic provisions of the charter.
My personal take on this is that once we subject that to the referendum in 2025, probably it may create more problems and more delays, because once we resume session in July, the president will be delivering his SONA. Congress, both houses, the Senate and the House of Representatives, will be busy tackling the national expenditure program, the budget for 2025, and there won't be simply enough time for us to sit down and discuss the merits of this proposal. I'm looking at probably have this done in within the year, maybe last quarter of this year. Why not? If we can do it within the year, why wait until 2025?
On Tuesday night, Deputy Majority Leader Neptali Gonzalez II maintained that the House will not submit a draft of the COMELEC without the Senate's nod. Gonzalez also disputed criticisms that Congress will have too much power and be exposed to lobby money if it gets the power to regulate foreign investments.
Unless otherwise provided by law, is Mr. Speaker, it centralizes a lot of power unto Congress, Mr. Chair, to amend the Constitution. Congress will be buffeted by intense lobbying and lobby money from transnational corporations and many interests, Mr. Speaker, Mr. Chair, to have their beneficial provision in the Constitution.
Nanakot lang yan eh. Nanakot that we will be exposed to, if you give the power to, legislative power to the Congress to change the proportion of ownership as provided for by the, masasubject daw kami sa mga, alam mo na, mga maglalabi. Sa akin, pananakot lang yan eh.
Former Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio, for his part, wants to introduce conditions to prevent possible abuse or influence from lobbying.
Then I propose that the amendment should read as follows, and I quote, unless otherwise provided by law, subject to reciprocity and two-thirds vote of all the members of the Senate and of the House of Representatives.
During the House's Chacha hearing Wednesday, Colmenares warned that giving foreign investors more access to public utilities may not be good for public service and national security. Carpio, meantime, believes it's more appropriate to just allow foreign investors to invest in colleges and graduate schools. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.